state finals for the 1985 Miss America pageant with our host Al Reynolds, musical director Giordano Martinez, choreographer Jill Lilly, and special guest Miss Cynthia Webber. And of course, the 35 stars of our show vying for the title of Miss Illinois 1984. Ladies and gentlemen, you will see a mixture of show business, a reaffirmation of faith in America, and a competition for a share of the largest scholarship foundation for young women in the world. Let us now meet these young women, one of whom will be Miss Illinois 1984.
We have a lady with a smiley face out there holding it up for everybody. I don't think they have a smile a lot. They're hysterical right at this point. Our next semifinalist, Miss Ottawa. Here we go.
Sorry, Olivia, you don't watch that soap opera. Has been wrapped in bandages.
because the actress
has amnesia.
She has amnesia, right? Which is the best way to be, I suppose, wrapped in bandages and not remembering a thing while you're wrapped in bandages. And the actress playing Betsy has lots of scenery, therefore they need to replace her.
The only thing you can see now are eyelashes.
How would you like to have been hired to sit there in bandages for a half an hour batting your eyelashes?
You pay for it.
Yeah, well, that makes it all worthwhile. Maybe we can talk deal here. I can bat eyelashes very well. We want to talk to you very briefly about the balloting system that our judges go through and how the points are put together. We know that 50% of all points scored go into the field of talent competition, and then the remaining 50% are divided equally among interview, among swimsuit. Are you laughing for some particular reason? Why is it?
That's been explained to the girls that 15 times.
Yeah.
Very proud to reject
that. You want to read that card, Jen?
Portray Jack Collins doing the balloting system last night.
Oh, this is something I missed.
Yes, you missed it. I don't know where you were.
You can keep the card, Jack. I think it's worth telling everybody that 50 for the challenge, 50 divided equally among all the other areas. So keep in mind now that, however, we start fresh. All the points are erased. The 10 young ladies start clean in the balloting system. None of the cumulative points getting into the top 10 enter in to the points now being scored by our panel of judges. So they will be casting totally new ballots. And by the end of the evening, a total of new points, one of the 10 young ladies that we met will have the chance to be Miss Illinois. Now that task, kind of an awesome responsibility, is in the hands of our judges. Awesome. Would you say that is awesome, Joel? Joel would say that. And we'd like to introduce them to you, for those of you for the first time here this evening, this is who they are.
Our first judge is making a return to Illinois, having been here in 1981. Fred has been associated with the Miss America Pageant program since 1973. He resides in Carlisle, Ohio, where he is superintendent of schools. Please welcome Mr. Fred Wolf.
Currently a field director in New Jersey, our next judge is also making a return visit here to Illinois. She is president of MLK Associates at Princeton Junction. Say hello to Mary Lee King.
And from our neighboring state to the east, we have the president of the Miss Indiana Pageant. He became associated with the Miss America Pageant program some 27 years ago. From Plymouth, Indiana, please welcome Don Warnson.
A first-time visitor to the Miss Illinois Pageant, our next judge comes from Pennsylvania. Among her many responsibilities, she serves as talent advisor to Miss Pennsylvania. Please give a warm Illinois welcome to Sister Eric Marie Setline.
And our last judge, he is a tough judge. He has judged me before. I know this one personally. Our last judge has served the Miss America Pageant program since 1968, serving his 13th year as the Miss Minnesota Pageant Executive Producer. He is a director for the National Association of Miss America State Pageants. From Austin, Minnesota, say hello to Joel Nelson.
And two other young men in the pit there did such a great job the other evening. They have come back for a return visit. They represent the accounting firm of McLandry, Hendrickson, and Pullen in Schaumburg, Illinois. They are our auditors. They are Bob Jensen and Gary Mashing. Bob and Gary. Now, we have some other duties to do, so if you'll stay right here with me, we'll introduce some people. Could we have the house lights up just for a bit? And we'd like you to welcome Miss Illinois, 1982, Jalee Jeffers White. We also have your mother and sister. I'll ask you to introduce them.
I introduce my mother, Gail Bush, mother, Ruth Ann.
time?
Well, the first area of competition for our 10 semifinals is that of swimsuit. In this, our judges will be looking to see the poise, the confidence, and the pride that each of our contestants exhibits on stage. Our contestants are ready, so let's bring on our 10 semifinals in swimsuit competition. Thank you. Tonight, the most talented non-finalist will receive a special $100 scholarship award from Chew On Chewing Gum. We would like to thank the Chew On executives who are with us here this evening, Bob Anderson, Vice President of Marketing, and Gary Kearney, Director of Marketing. And all the girls would like to thank these two individuals for all the Chew On samples they've had back at the dormitory. We here in the auditorium had a chance to try it last night. It's got an interest in it. It's terrific. Let me tell you, Chew's great Chew On chewing gum. We thank them. We're also pleased to welcome the gentleman from the United States Air Force Recruiting Service, the 3551st Recruiting Squadron. They have been escorting our young ladies, certainly on in the opening production number. They'll escort our young ladies on stage during the evening gown competition in the second half of our program. And also, Cameo Couture's Dallas, Texas, have provided robes for each of our contestants and a $300 wardrobe for our new Miss Illinois. The contestants of the Miss America Pageant program present talents that they hope will win them scholarship money to further their education. That's what this program is all about. A young lady from a neighboring state, Iowa, to be exact, became involved in the program for this very reason. Not only is she very talented, she has that beauty which comes from the magic combination of poise, charm, and self-confidence, the special qualities that make her more than just a pretty young lady. Would you please welcome back to our stage for her fourth night, Miss Cindy Weber, Miss Muscatine, Iowa, 1984.
Thank you. their own executive producer, Jim Marks. The Miss Illinois Pageant feels that exceptional talent should be recognized, and tonight is no exception. It is with great pleasure that we present the contestant who scored the highest number of talent points among the non-finalists. Would you please join me in congratulating Miss Freeport, Karina Bonham. Enjoy yourself at Miss America. Talent is a very important phase of the Miss Illinois pageant. We told you at the beginning of our program that it scores 50% of the balloting. It enables our contestants to express their individuality so that our judges may see them in a performance situation. We begin now with the talent phase of the Miss Illinois pageant. We all have dreams that lead us onward. In keeping with that, tonight, our next contestant has chosen to sing for us tonight the hit song from the musical Annie entitled Tomorrow. Contestant number 32, Miss Wabash Valley, Tammy Renee Harris. Fantasy and Variation on an American Air by Wilhelm Pop is the first selection chosen by our next contestant to play for you. She is contestant number 12. She is Miss Pia, and her name is Holly Jarvis.
Thank you.
Here's a zing of memories and hope for the future is contestant number one, Miss Chicago, Ruth Booker. She'll be singing Kiss Me in the Rain. routine to the song 1981. Here is contestant number 31, Miss Latavia Maurice Phelan.
Thank you.
Our next contestant singing the title song from the motion picture Endless Love is Miss Charleston Delta Chi. Please welcome contestant number 19, Julie Mann.
Thank you.
our program. You will have a 20-minute intermission to rest and work out the kinks, and we'll be back when you join us. In this particular area, the judges will be looking for boys. personality, self-expression, and charm. Our contestants are ready, so let's welcome our 10 semifinalists in evening gown competition.
Thank you.
Thank you. Well, the competition is concluded. Judges now have to vote for this final vote on evening gown. And the way it works, a final ballot will be passed among the judges. They will make one final vote among five young ladies who are in the final top five, and they will vote for those five with additional points. We'll total the final ballot, and in short order, we will have a new Miss Illinois. At this time, there are people that we would like to thank for contributions to the Miss Illinois pageant. These people are not part of our staff, but they have assisted us in so many ways, making our stay here so enjoyable. We want to call their attention to you, your attention to them. Let me put it that way. It makes it simpler. Judson College, they have housed all of our contestants, and we thank Judson College for their fine support. Also, the Ramada Inn has opened their doors wide for us, and they have become pageant headquarters, and we thank the Ramada very much for fine accommodations and supplying warm hearts over there. The Chamber of Commerce here in Elgin has really opened the city to us and made us feel very welcome. The Pizza Hut on McLean Boulevard, Ackerman's Department Store. Somebody from Pizza Hut back there. Good to have you here. Giving it back for an early serving later tonight. Ackerman's Department Store. Chuck Hines of Barrington for the tuxedos. First National Bank of Elgin for the plaques, trophies, and crowns presented to our young ladies. And the judges have been hosted by a number of people, and we want to tell you who they all were. On Tuesday, they were hosted for the Chamber of Commerce, Mike McGrath. On Wednesday, they were hosted at the Butterman's, Fernando Nigers. On Thursday, they were hosted by Crescent Construction of Crystal Lake, John Wegman. On Friday, they were hosted by the Blue Moon, Skip Morris. And on Friday the 13th, I heard a lot of strange things happen on Friday the 13th. No. Saturday, the milk pail, that was tonight, hosted by the milk pail. Thank you. I've not lived in the milk pail, but here's a great place. Hosted by Mr. and Mrs. J. Frederick Baker of Leland, Illinois. Why don't you give all those people a nice round? The Miss Illinois pageant is a not-for-profit Illinois corporation administered by volunteers from all over the state. These people receive no monetary compensation for their efforts. Their pageant work begins after their business day is over, on weekends and on holidays. And many take their vacations to come to Elgin to make this week possible for the young ladies that you have all had a chance to meet tonight. Under the Illinois State Charter, the pageant profits are required to be returned to the contestants in the form of scholarships. In 1983, the Miss Illinois pageant and its affiliated local pageants awarded more than $65,000 in scholarships to contestants, thereby making a significant contribution to the education of Illinois' young women. It is through these scholarships our contestants are able to prepare themselves for a very changing world. In the Miss America program in general, throughout our country, did you know that over $2,500,000 is awarded annually? And that's why we call this a scholarship pageant program. Miss America this year will be awarded a $25,000 college scholarship. And the scholarships don't stop there. All young ladies who go to Atlantic City will be guaranteed at least a $1,500 scholarship. The first runner-up will receive a $15,000 scholarship. The second runner-up a $10,000 scholarship. The third runner-up a $7,000 scholarship. The fourth runner, $5,000. And five semifinalists, $3,000 each. So it goes without saying that this is a scholarship program. Before sharing her final moments with us is Miss Illinois. Lovely Becky Bush has a special musical number for you. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Illinois, Becky Bush.
I'm
As I take the ramp for my final walk, it barely seems possible a year has gone by since I won the title of Miss Illinois. I am so grateful to have had the opportunity to represent Illinois and participate in the Miss America Scholarship Program. Through my participation, I was able to complete my education at the University of Mississippi. I have made many wonderful friendships during my travels this past year, the memories I will treasure forever.
I think the crew is eating it right back there right now. At least Mr. Parks took it out of my hands, so that gives you an idea. He had a giant straw in the other hand, and he went right to work on it. You know, this is a great country of ours. We like it a lot. I hope everybody does. It's a great place to have a chance to get to know one another. It's a great place to express ourselves. It's a great place to meet fine people like our judges here. It's a great place to come to know so many people who are out there. If you're sitting in the audience and you don't know your neighbor, shame on you for not introducing yourself, because this country gives you that opportunity to do that. If your neighbor can smile at you and there's a piece of spinach between their teeth, shame on you for not telling us that. It's your duty to allow them to embarrass themselves any longer by doing that. But we have a production number that girls and I have tried to work up, and I've tried to remember the words each night. Last night we just sort of made up lyrics, so they just all sort of fit together. We're going to try it one more time, because this is a grand country with a grand old flag. There's a people that come to steal it, really set my brain to reeling when I'm listening to the music of that military band. And just like any doodle, really knocks me off my noodle. It's that mystery song that goes and goes from time to time again. Way down south in the land of cotton love, oh, the inspiring, ain't that inspiring? Hurrah, hurrah, the choices will be. And that going song for the Yankee Triumph, when I am loose, I am loose, I'm your grand old flag. You're a grand old Mr. new Miss Illinois cannot fulfill her duties, our first runner-up would secede to the throne. Our first runner-up is Miss North Region, Rhonda.